Astute Graphics has just moved over to the annual service plan. This gives customers great benefits, including access to all our plugins at a reduced cost and the ability to gain the new tools that we have planned in our roadmap. But it's the small improvements that we plan to release regularly that are possibly even more important to many customers. These are the ones which have been requested, and the first one we're going to show is in VectorScribe. And I'm going to go to the window menu, find VectorScribe, and I'm going to open the PathScribe panel. Now, this artwork consists of a simple heart which had a beveled stroke applied to it, and you can see it's a bevel, you see this sort of join type here. And that has already been expanded, and so when it was passed to me, I have no chance of changing that sort of stroke type to another one before expanding again. It's already been done. And what I want to do is refine it. First of all, I want to really make points on the top and the bottom where there are currently 2 points where these paths sort of go around a corner. But also I want to have a little experiment. I want to show you a new feature. I'm going to go to the Direct Select tool, and I'm going to select 2 points, no more or no less. They can be on the same paths, they can be on different paths. I'm just going to select 2 points. And in this case, I can see the shortest distance in the units of measurement of this document, so in this case, inches, between these 2 points is 7.5, roughly, inches between them. So firstly, I've got a very quick way of measuring distances. That's very nice. The other thing I can do is look at this button here, and it's an average button. So I can click on this button and it will move the 2 points, not merge them together, but move the 2 points into the average. So basically the center between those 2 points. And in this case, it can create some really quite dramatic artwork. So there I can move that. Brilliant. Let's look at it down at the bottom of this heart here. And I'm going to select 2 points here. And again, it shows me this very small distance between them. And now I'm going to average those 2 points. Now what it's done is to actually put the 2 points coincidentally on top of each other. And we're actually creating a redundant point. I'll demonstrate what I mean by selecting this point and moving out of the way. You can see the other point is still there. But that's no problem in PathScribe. All I do when I have a redundant point, this button becomes highlighted, click on it, and now it's a single point. So I have first averaged them into the same location, and then I've quickly removed them with a single click of a button. Let's go to the top of this. And this is a genuine bit of artwork which was expanded using Adobe Illustrator's stroke expansion method. And I'm going to have a look here. This actually tripped me up earlier when I was practicing. And I can see that it's actually created 2 points very nearly on top of each other when it expanded the stroke. Sometimes these sort of artifacts come about. It's because of maths and because of the complexity of things. So I'm not going to go into that, but it's very, very annoying on how to try and get rid of it. Because they're not quite on top of each other, these 2 points, which look like 1 point now, you can't really use the removal button here. But if I select both of these points, I can see there's 0.0002 inches between them. So effectively on top of each other. Can't click that, so let me just average them, and then let me click the remove redundant point button to make it a single point again. And now if I want to merge these two together, I can click on average again and remove redundant point once more, and I have my sharp corner at the top of the heart as well. I hope that is a quick demonstration of what customers can suggest and look to gain in their future toolset. Next, I want to demonstrate the minor enhancements to ColliderScribe, specifically its SpaceFill function set, which can be found by going to the Window menu, ColliderScribe, and opting for SpaceFill panel. Now, with this scene I have here, I have created a very plain rectangle over the whole scene, and this rectangle has got no fill and no stroke, so basically it's a container. I've also drawn out a single snowflake that I want to replicate over the scene. Now here's a larger version of it, and it's basically a hexagon with a gradient on it, and the gradient fades out with transparency. It's quite a simple single object. And I've scaled this object down, and I've got a little instance of it here. Now in a stacking order, that's been placed above the rectangle that I demonstrated earlier. So I'm going to select both objects together. So the rectangle container and that little snowflake. I'm going to go to the space fill panel and I'm going to start applying that as a space fill object. So please look at our space fill videos to find out more about this, but effectively it's trying to get that object and fill that container as many times as possible with that object. So at the moment there's only one instance, so that's stuck in the middle. So I'm going to click on the multiply filling art option here, and I'm going to go for 500 of those snowflakes. Now you can start to see the snowflakes dotted around very nicely spaced out. A bit of randomness to it, so the uniformity isn't at the top. It's quite low, actually, uniformity, which I want with the snowflakes, but it still isn't realistic. There's no variation going on. So as per the previous versions, I can vary the size. So some of them will be 5 times larger now, and some of them will be the same size, and variances in between. And as before, I can vary the rotation, but now I have the option to say how much I want this object to be able to spin around. And rather than being able to spin the full 360 degrees randomly, I only want to spin about 15 degrees. It's much more subtle. And you'll see that some of the snowflakes are a little bit twisted, some aren't. It's that subtlety that makes it a bit more realistic. But here's the other new feature, and that's the ability to vary the opacity of each of these instances. This is a very, very welcome feature and has been requested several times. And I can, by clicking on it, vary the opacity from 0% to 100%. So the ones in the foreground here, which are quite clear snowflakes, they are 100% opaque. But I may want to knock it down a little bit to say 90%. So some are completely transparent, 0% opacity, and some are 90%. So I can touch this one up a bit as well to 10 to 90% until I'm happy with it. And if I want to randomize it a bit more, it's a bit like throwing a stack of cards out, see what happens, just throw it down and see what happens again and again and again until you get the effect you like. So I'll do it one more time, and there we go, that's a nice effect. So that single object has been taken by SpaceFill, replicated, and with varied transparency and varied rotation plus or minus 15 degrees. Our final minor change relates to ColliderScribe once more. And this time I'm going to go into the ColliderScribe toolset by clicking and holding on the selection tool and opting for Snap to Collisions tool. With the Snap to Collisions tool, I can select any object and snap it to either its previous location or a new object like I'm demonstrating here. Now in the previous version, any collision acted visually, but if I were to move this away, for example, you'd see that there's no evidence of a collision having taken place on the actual paths. Now, if I go into the preferences for ColliderScribe by either double-clicking on the tool or hitting the Enter or Return key, I can look at the new option of Add Points to Paths at Collisions and enable it like this. You'll also notice, by the way, that we have put the modern help system at the bottom of this panel now to match the other modern plugins, so that when you scroll over these options, you can see what they actually do. Anyway, I'm going to click on OK, having added the Add Points option. And back in the tool, I will now collide these two objects together. And at this intersection, I will pull this away once more. And you'll see there's a point now present here, and there's a point now present here where the collision took place. You can also turn this option on and off on the fly by going to the tool, and when the mouse is held down, hit the letter A on the keyboard, and it'll tell you that Add Points is disabled, or hit it again to re-enable it. If you have an idea for a small addition to one of our existing plugins, don't hesitate to drop us a line. Send us an email or contact us on social media, and we'll be more than happy to see what is possible and what can be put in a relatively short time. We really look forward to hearing what you have to say. Thank you very much.